blessed them and said, Be fruitful and multiply, subdue the earth. By uniting them, you made one flesh of the two. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two become one body. And what God has united, man must not separate. By opening Sarah's womb, you blessed your servant Abraham and made him the father of many nations. You gave Isaac to Rebekah and blessed her when she bore children. You joined Jacob to Rachel and drew the 12 patriarchs from his line. You made Joseph one with the Senate and gave them Ephraim and Manasseh as the fruit of childbirth. You accepted Zachary and Elizabeth and made their offspring the forerunner. You made their virgin sprout into flesh from the root of Jesse, and taking flesh from her, you were born for the human race. You went to Canaan in Galilee with your unexpected gift and abundant goodness, and blessed the marriage there in order to show your approval of lawful wedlock and its fruit, the birth of children. Most Holy Master, accept our prayer when your servants made. Because you went to Cana, bless this marriage after coming here too with your now unseen presence, and give these servants of yours, Nicholas and Lara, a peaceful life, length of days, chastity, love for one another, and a bond of peace, long-lived descendants, gratitude for their children, and an unfading crown of glory. Let them see their children's children, keep their bed unassailed, give to them of the dew of the heavens above and of the fertility of the earth. Fill their houses with grain, wine, and oil, yes, with every good thing, so that they in turn may share with those in need. At the same time, grant to those present here with them every request helpful towards salvation. For you are a God of mercy, compassion, and befriending love. And to you, with your beginningless Father and your most holy, good, and life-giving, creating Spirit, we send up glory, now and forever and ever.